Hello, everybody, and welcome to Loras College Basketball, where the Kau College Quahogs travel to Lillis Court to take on the Loras College Jayhawks in what should be a fantastic matchup in ARC tournament play. Adam, who do we have on our lineups today?
For the Jayhawks, obviously you want to look at number 11, Sammy Martin, the sophomore. Great, great post player, leading the team in points, and is actually second in the ARC for points in total. And with that, you also want to look at Madison Fleckenstein, another great forward for the Jayhawks, second leading scorer on the team. Those two are definitely key players for the Jayhawks. As for the Quahogs, you definitely want to look over at Kalen Peterson, almost averaging a double-double throughout the season. I mean, that's very impressive. 9.7 points per game and 9.8 rebounds per game. Along with third, watch out for Ellie Wissner, averaging about almost 15 points a game. Definitely is the leading scorer. So those are two people you want to look out for on the Quahogs. As you said, this should be a very, very exciting game as we are in the first round of the ARC tournament here. So it could be close, and it could come down to the wire. Who knows?
Who knows? I mean, the Jayhawks have had a run themselves. They really have had a good season, 18-7, 12-4 in the conference. And, you know, just trying to get it together here before, you know, the game starts. And we'll be back once introductions are done. All right, let's meet our starting lineups for tonight. Adam, who do you got?
Yeah, for the visiting Kau College Quahogs, manning the paint is number 33, Kalen Peterson. And in the front court with her is number 22, Ellie Wisner, and number 24, Katie Wilhelmy. And in the back court for the Quahogs, we have number 5, Molly Buck, and number 1, Elise Southern. And for the Loras College Jayhawks, manning paint, number 11, Sammy Martin. Joining her down there is number 24, Madison Haslow, and number 35, Madison Fleckenstein. And bringing it up for the Jayhawks is number 5, Sarah Bachman, and number 14, Sydney Schuler.
I mean, we talked about how well the Jayhawks have done, but Madison Fleckenstein has really been a key part of that team. 321 points this season and earned herself ARC Athlete of the Week. Yep. And so top performances by her as they went on a 2-1 little run there for this past week, beat Luther 78-63, taking down University of Dubuque 88-82 on Wednesday, cross city rivalry there, but had a bit of a marathon run with number 19 Wartburg College, fell short 95-86. Tip off underway. The Cubs gonna win this one.
You know, you talked about Fleckenstein. I talked about her earlier, and you said earning that ARC Player of the Week. I mean, I don't know how you don't give it to her last game against, like you said, number 19 Wartburg. She finished with 24 points and 7 rebounds, a near double-double along with 3 steals in 42 minutes in their double overtime loss, which is unfortunate. But, yeah, well-deserved by Fleck.
Yeah, I mean, just kind of, you know, it's a no-brainer at that point, and it looks like – Sydney Schuler is going to get charged with a foul there. Wilhelm misses one, but makes up and makes the second one. Fleckenstein's going to bring this one up, gives it to Bachman. Haslow thought about it, dishes it off to Fleckenstein. Now back to Martin. Haslow has been hot from behind the arc, and she gets fouled here. And you talk about how well the DuHawks have done. How much of that three-point shooting game has contributed to their success all year?
I mean, it's definitely one of their strongest parts of their games. I mean, you look at their percentage throughout as a team. They're shooting about 35% as a team, which for three-point range, beautiful move from Martin, unable to finish there. But 35% as a team, it is very good. I mean, you don't really hear high 30s or like even 40s that much. So the mid-30 range is very solid for a team, and wouldn't be surprised if they get many points from threes tonight.
Yeah, and you talk about solid numbers. They're ranked second in the ARC for three. Is that three is no good from a Quahog. Southard tried to put that one in but couldn't fall. Fleckenstein's going to get it to Haslow at the top of the three, and that one is just short. Picked up.
Interesting to see that one not fall. Haslow, a very, very good three-point shooter on the team, averaging 47% from behind the arc. And I just said it, that percentage is just unheard of.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not a lot of players go 47 from the line.
And Martin takes this one coast to coast and gets her first points of the game. DuHawks up by one and a 2-1 lead. And Haslow really, you know, we talked about Fleckenstein being a key. Haslow also a sharp shooter from behind the arc, 47-99. From there, as the Quahogs trying to set something up, trying to get some points, not off from the free throw line. Molly Buck gets the shot off and makes that one. As Bachman's going to go coast to coast, as she gets this one pulled away from her. Picked up by Molly Buck again from the free throw line, and that one just short, picked up by Haslow. Bachman going to get this one to Schuler for a three, and that one is good. Schuler for a three, 5-3, DuHawks lead.
Another deadly three-point shooter there out of Sydney Schuler, especially if she gets going. That three is off.
Yeah.
If she gets going early, it's going to be a long, long game for the Quahogs if Schuler's making her, she's making her tray balls.
Her and Haslow, that dynamic duo, when they get hot from behind the arc, they are not someone you want to mess with.
Not at all.
We're going to get a couple subs in here. Jamie Ryan's coming in. Emerson Wittenbaugh and Hannah Thiel.
Looks like we're going to have Macy Rogers bring it in for the Quahogs into Southard. She checked in along with Ellie Walker and that little dead ball.
A shot. Walker in that one.
Walker
good.
Comes in the game and immediately is already taking shots. That's going to be big for the Quahogs there if those bench players can just come in and start hitting shots.
Ryan thought about a three, gets it to Wittenbaugh. Wittenbaugh now to Thiel. She's going to get it back to Ryan. Sammy Martin trying to work the inside, but gets the ball taken away from her. Molly Buck.
Travel call.
A mistake made by many. It happens to the best of us. Fleckenstein's going to check back in and up and down.
Sure does. I mean, we've seen already, DuHawks have had multiple turnovers so far in the early minutes of this first quarter. You don't really see that quite a bit from them. I definitely want to limit that if they're going to want to win this game.
Yep, limitations on turnovers are a huge benefactor. Fleckenstein's going to bank that three. So a three-point lead for the DuHawks. Fleckenstein getting it going here for them.
Good steal from Bachman there. It looks like she might go coast-to-coast here.
Yeah. She's going to kick it back out to Fleckenstein. Another three, and that one just off the backboard. Picked up by a Quahog. Alyssa Southard's going to get this to Ellie Walker back to Macy Rogers.
Like
And that one's going to go over the backboard for Molly Buck.
A couple substitutions here. In for the Duhawks is number 31, Daniela Durrell. Number 32 for the Quahawks, Emily Sly. And I think she was the only one checking in.
Durrell's going to get it to Fleckenstein in the paint. She's going to get fouled and is going to find herself at the free throw line.
A very nice find from Durrell there.
Yep, a freshman coming into the Duhawk team. Really good trying to build that chemistry as Haslow's going to check in for Ryan here. And you talk about the Duhawks really being an inclusive team. I think she fits right in with what they're trying to do and what they're trying to build. And like we said, the great thing about it is she's a freshman. So getting this experience early on is really going to help not just her, but her teammates too.
Yeah, you know, and with this team, they're all about culture and all about having that good chemistry, like you said. So definitely having those freshmen getting the time, and even in practices too, they love to work in those freshmen, make sure that they're building that culture and that team strength that they want. Good steal from Hazard there.
Fleckenstein makes those pair of free throws, but she's going to get it to Thiel for a three, and that one just off the backboard, picked up by Macy Rogers.
I think for the Duhawks, it might have been it was definitely an off shooting night for the Quahawks, but the last game these two teams met, Loras came out with victory. Good shot from Walker there.
Indeed.
Loras came out with a 76-57 W against the Quahawks, and I think if you're Loras, you want to look at letting Co shoot from deep.
Yep.
Not a very good three-point shooting team. They'll knock them down, but definitely not the strongest part of their game. They only shot 14% from three in the last matchup. So let's see if the Duhawks just let them live from outside.
Yeah, Wittenbaugh is going to get the ball taken away from her, and it looks like an offensive foul. And a trio of Quahawks are going to check in. Ella Imler. And Katie Wilhelm are going to check in. Molly Buck deciding what she wants to do. She's going to dribble, and she's going to try to drive in, but falls at the free throw line.
Good D from Thiele there.
Indeed. Quahawks trying to work on the inside, going to kick it out to Buck. She's going to drive in. She's going to get this to a teammate, and that one's in just before the shot clock goes off, and that's going to count. So that lead that the Duhawks have is now down to one. Haslow trying to extend it as she's going to get this to Wittenbaugh, and they're going to inbound it.
I mean, it was great defense from the Duhawks that entire possession until that final second. They just had a miscommunication and left, I believe it was Peterson, just open right at the elbow.
Yeah, and you know it's a good possession defensively when that shot clock is clicking down, and everyone's trying to get open frantically, but it just paid off for the Quahawks there. The Duhawks did their part in trying to get them to shoot, but it just benefited the Quahawks just a little bit more. As Haslow's going to drive in, she's going to get this one blocked. Peterson blocking shots left and right, but Buck for a three, and that one is no good. Oh, looked like it was off of Quahawk, but she picks it up.
Well, Hamid's three is no good.
Martin's going to give this to Bachman at the top of the key. Bachman, Schuler, looking for some options here. He's going to give it back to Bachman in the corner. She's going to drive in a little behind the back pass that was intended for Martin, but off of a Quahawk foot. Fleckenstein's going to check in for the sharpshooter Haslow.
Now, we just saw it there. Peterson, not one to be afraid to block your shots, averaging about two a game. So definitely Duhawks going to want to try to get her up in the air, draw some fouls, and get to the line, as they are all very solid free throw shooters.
Yeah, you talk about blocks. Cohawks are third in the ARC for those. Bachman's three is nothing but net. And she's getting hot from behind the line. 13-9, Duhawks. So the Duhawks making a living from behind the arc, it seems like, this game. And we're just in the first quarter, 2.5 minutes left. Buck gets this one in to Wilhelm, but that one's going to get interrupted.
Good hand from Bachman there.
Bachman's going to give this to Schuler. Depended on a three, but said no way. Gives it to Martin. Bachman back to Martin in the paint. Going to put this one up. Just a little bit more on that, and that is nothing but net.
You do not see that a lot from Martin. That is usually – that is her shot there. To see her airball it short, very, very interesting.
Yeah, that's her bread and butter play, but sometimes – you can't make them all.
From Bachman.
Bachman's going to poke that one. Fleckenstein with the pickup, and Fleckenstein with the points. A little poke and go there from the Duhawks.
Cole moving it around well into Peterson. Good charge from Fleck there.
Fleckenstein going to get the defensive foul. And the Duhawk bench is happy about that. Hasla's going to check in for Ryan. Bachman going to get in a play, and Schuler's going to run across the baseline. And this one's going to get interrupted.
Bachman is very lucky Walker didn't take that all the way down to our side. I mean, you can't have this pass where you're just showing the defender where you're going. Very easy to read and very easy to steal those kinds of passes.
So off of a Cohawk, and Bachman's going to try to set it up again. Fleckenstein is going to drive in, and that looked like it was intended for Martin, but picked up by Bachman.
Oh, yeah.
Haslow!
Ooh.
Fleckenstein tried to save the ball there, but couldn't in time. So it's going to be the Cohawks ball.
Unfortunate air ball there out of Haslow. Not one to air ball it very much.
So Southard's going to take this up. A minute left to play in the first period.
Oh, nice move.
And she's going to go in, but blocked by Martin. She lets you get past you, but she's going to make you pay for it.
Martin said, not in my house, Southard. Great defense there from Martin.
Most definitely. Duhawks trying to hold on to that 15-9 lead. Oh. But a three. And that one short. Fleckenstein gets the rebound.
Good hustle there from Southard. I love that attempt for that offensive rebound.
Yep, Haslow. One of the three, but it's going to give it to Martin on the inside. She's going to work it, and she misses that one off the rim.
That's just, great recovery from Peterson there. Overhelped just a little bit too much for that pass to get in, but she recovered great, and now she's going to go to work, and,
Peterson
off the rim.
Peterson's shot is no good. Picked up by Haslow, and she's going to get it to Bachman. So 15 seconds left in the first period. Duhawks. No need for a shot clock, so you bet they're going to bank off that last-second shot. Who's it going to be? That's the question. Martin going to drive in with 3 seconds left.
Great take.
She's going to draw the foul, so she's going to get 2 shots there. In terms of team fouls already, the Duhawks got 2. Cohawks sitting at 5. And Martin... this year from the free throw line, 72-91. Doesn't get much better than that. Let's make it 73-92. That one just in and out. And Fleckenstein tries to bank it off a Cohawk foot. So after period one, your Loras College Duhawks 16 and the Co-College Cohawks 9. Given what we've seen in the first period, Adam, what do you expect out of the Duhawks headed into the second period?
Going into the second quarter, wouldn't be surprised if they stay aggressive, try to get down low in the paint every time. I mean, they're doing it right now. We've seen it quite a bit. Peterson just gets a little too aggressive on some helps, but they're definitely going to want to live in the paint more. I mean, the last time these two teams met, Loras outscored Co. 42-28 in the paint. So definitely a strong suit for them. And in the second quarter, you're going to want to see the bench get involved more. You want to see the bench score a little more. The bench is a big factor in their last game against Co. Outscoring Co. 27-8. So, I mean, if you're Co., you're definitely going to want your bench to help you more, too. I mean, 8 points is just not enough from that secondary.
Indeed, and I think we've seen Co. put up the same amount of shots that Loras has put up from behind the arc. But Loras just, I mean, the stats speak for themselves. They've just been really good from behind the arc all year. And so Co. trying to match that intensity from the three-point line, I mean, it can help you, but you want to make good shots. You want to make shots that you know you can make. And that'll add up as you go on throughout the game. So as we head into the second, Fleckenstein's going to inbound it for the Duhawks. Bachman going to fake a couple passes, but gets it to Haslow. Haslow guarded heavily. Fleckenstein to Bachman for a three, and that one's no good. Picked up by Martin, and Fleckenstein. Good from the paint. So a 9-point lead for the Duhawks. Walker's going to drive in for the Cohawks, and that one's no good. Picked up by Haslow. And for someone who's got such great shooting skills as Haslow does, she's got great handles as well. She can pass the ball crisply. She's got great dribbling skills. I mean, everything that she does is just so perfect. Fleckenstein going to drive in. Kick this one's out to Haslow for a three, and that one just short. Off of Duhawk, it looks
off
like.
Off of Fleck, looks to be. It's going to go the other way. Now, we said look out for Peterson. She's been kind of quiet tonight. I guess first quarter, we definitely think you'd see a little more coming out of her for the Cohawks, especially if they want to have a solid chance of winning this game. I think you need your star big to really produce for them.
Indeed. I mean, she's 73 offensive rebounds, 171 defensive rebounds, second in the ARC for that. Hazel's going to flip this one out to Schuler. And I mean, Bachman to Martin, and that one's good.
I mean, for the Duhawks, that's going to be there every time. It's not just Peterson over helping. This Cohawks team is really aggressive on that help when they drive to the paint. They help almost just – they help way too much, and it just allows those easy layups for the Duhawks. So I think if you're Co., you're going to want to try to back down on that help in the paint and limit those points close to the bucket.
I mean, you can really tell the aggressiveness on defense from Co. just by watching how – well, they press on defense. Ryan and Thiel are going to check in for Fleckenstein and Schuler. As Co. is going to inbound it here. Southard is going to get it to Winsner. Winsner to Walker. She's going to drive in. Kicks it out to Wilhelm. And that three is no good. Picked up by Bachman. She's going to take this one for herself. It's going to stop at the free throw line. Thiel is going to get a push off here.
No, I think they're calling that on Wilhelmy.
My correction. Wilhelmy is going to get called with a push off. And
Macy Rogers is going to check in.
Yeah, Rogers is going to check in for them. Haslow to inbound it. And Bachman's going to get this to Martin. Martin deciding what to do. She gets it to Haslow on the inside, and that's good. So 22-11, 11-point lead for the Duhawks already. And they're cooking with some fire here.
Again, just too much help and just a little too aggressive on defense, allowing the Duhawks to get a lot of those backdoor cuts, get easy layups. Good jumper there for Wisner.
Wisner, 119 for 323 for the field goals. Bachman's going to get this to the inside for Martin. She's going to go to work in the paint.
And
that's
an
and
one.
A potential three-point play from Martin.
Good. Good to see her getting some buckets, get her going early. Flex going to check back in for Haslow along with Peterson. Looks like Wittenbaugh is going to wait for the free throw. Come check in for Martin here.
You talk about Martin's aggressiveness in the paint, 144 for 262 from the field goals. And, I mean, she gets a break and Wittenbaugh checks in, a much-deserved one, too.
We talked about, I mentioned her being second in the conference in scoring with total points. And with that, she hasn't taken a single three this season. So all those points are coming from either the line or just getting big and making moves and scoring in the paint. It's very impressive out of Martin, obviously, with how the game of basketball been now. A lot of threes are shot, so I love to see how she's staying to what she knows how to do and love seeing how she's just going to her strengths.
Yeah, and I think, too, like when you can do what you do and have the success you've had from inside, from the paint, from the field goal, getting those shots off, there's no need to discover something from behind the arc. If you can make a living off of what you've done so far, just stick to that.
Very true.
So the Quahawks take a timeout here. A 12-point lead, 7 minutes left in the first half. Trying to turn it around here. Southard's going to take this up, and she's going to get it to Winsner. A field goal, and that one's no good. Picked up by Wittenbaugh. So Ryan back to Wittenbaugh. And Bachman's going to give it to Thiel. And the Duhawks play a really good game from getting passes in from behind the arc. And that's something that they can do to get something set up. Whether they want to get a shot off or work it into the inside, they can move in slowly and still take time off the clock, but still also make sure everybody's getting involved.
No doubt. And what I love about the Duhawks and how they're playing right now, I love their transition right now. Everything seems to be going. They want to get this game moving. I think they want to make Co play faster than what I think they usually do. I haven't really seen. I mean, they like to transition quite a bit, but this transition tonight is a little different from previous games.
Southard's three, and that's good.
Good shot there from Southard. 31% three-point shooter on the season. It's not surprised that she's taking those shots and making them.
Bachman's going to drive in here, and she's going to get fouled, so she'll find herself at the line for a pair of shots. And Sierra Bachman, a huge leader, not just because she's a point guard, but also just her skill, too, taking control of the offense and being able to come up with rebounds. I mean, I've seen her multiple times this game just get in there, get in the paint, take the ball for herself, and goes coast to coast or holds it up for her teammates to get down and set something up. And not that the big guys like Wittenbaugh or Fleckenstein or Martin aren't having a good game on the boards. That just shows the type of aggressiveness she's got. And that one falls in after it dabbles a little bit with the rim. So both her shots fall in as another timeout is taken, this time by by Loras. So given, you know, the Duhawks' success all year and everything, finished up the season 18-7, 12-4 in the conference, and being able to put up a good game, I mean, a double overtime game against a nationally ranked Wartburg team says a lot about the aggressiveness and the fight that this Duhawk team has in them. And I think it says, too, a lot about the coaching with Coach Hines being as good as a coach as he is. I mean, the record he has here at Loras is unparalleled to anything I think I've ever seen. So hats off to him and his team.
Yeah, no doubt. And you said a double OT game against Wartburg, just an unfortunate loss. I mean, they were with it, and then just double overtime came, and Wartburg outscored the Duhawks. I believe it was 16-5. Just, I mean, Wartburg really found shots to fall, and then Loras just couldn't really get anything going in that second overtime. But with the tournament, as we said, this is the first round of the ARC Conference Tournament. The winner of this will travel to Wartburg to play Wartburg in the semifinals on the 24th, so on Wednesday. Thursday. And so you want to think the Duhawks have that in the back of their head, thinking, all right, let's win this and let's go to Wartburg and see if we can finally get that win over them. In the two games they've played, they are 0-2 against Wartburg, lost both. The very first game against Wartburg this season, absolute heartbreaker again, losing on the last second shot. Thiele's three is no good, but you want to think that's what they're aiming for too, and then going to Simpson, possibly, if they get there. I mean, yeah, they're going to have to go through UD and Luther in the semifinals. The winner of that game will play Simpson. I mean, Simpson, a very good team, I think ranked in the top 10 for women's basketball. So you wouldn't be surprised, yeah, you see them going to the conference championship.
And I think, too, you know, Wartburg and Simpson both have a bye, so that gives them time to rest up scout teams like Loras, scout teams like Luther, and say, hey, this is what we're going against. This is what we did against them last time. But Thiele, she doesn't care about last time. She's focusing on the here and now.
Thiele, a very good three-point shooter, has a lot of range. She likes to put them up from deep, and she'll make them too. That's the thing. You can't really give her a lot of space.
364 shooting percentage from behind the arc for Thiele as Hazel's going to get the rebound. And Thiele can get it going from behind the arc too as needed, as she takes another shot and nothing but net on that one.
Yep.
Back-to-back threes for Thiele, and she's going to cause the Quahawks to call another timeout here. Yep. 35-18.
And if
Duhawks,
if you're Co, you do not want Thiele to start getting hot. I mean, I just said it. She pulls up from deep, and we just saw it there. She will pull from deep. I mean, you can't give her a lot of space. I mean, that hand down, man down, as we like to say, hand down, man down, and Thiele will punish you for those deep threes.
A deep three shooter. She's going to take a seat on the bench. Ryan checks in. Martin, Haslow, Bachman, and Schuler in for the Duhawks. 3:32 left in the second period. The Duhawks seem to be running away with this one, but nothing is certain, as we have learned in the past. Buck's going to get this to Winsner. Winsner making a decision, and she tried to get that one to Wilhelm. Bounces back to her, and she gets that shot off from the free throw line. It's going to get this to Southard for a three, and that one doesn't fall. Picked up by Haslow. Haslow, she's a three-point shooting
machine.
Oh, good
one more. Good one more.
Ooh. Ryan just short on that one. As good as Haslow is shooting, she's almost just as good from rebound, and Ryan is going to intercept that one. He's going to give it to Bachman. Schuler gives it back to Bachman at the top of the key, and she's going to set it up. Ryan thought about it in the corner. He's going to give it to Bachman in a one-step, and that one doesn't fall. Picked up by Southard and the Quahawks. And Jamie Ryan, I don't think she gets talked about enough. When she comes in the game, she is an aggressive person. She's always cheering her teammates on, always willing to play, always just doing the extra thing. She's kind of like that spark plug.
Yeah, I mean, like I said, she is all heart when she's on the court. It's unfortunate. I mean, she's a senior, so unfortunate for the team that they're going to have to lose her after this season. To me, like I said, she just hustle all heart, and she's just, yeah, she doesn't get talked about a lot. I mean, she doesn't score necessarily as much as some of the other players like Fleck and Martin, but it's little things that she does on the court for this team that, I mean, they stand out to a bunch of fans too, and obviously her team and coaches. So, I mean, props to her for just going out there and giving it everything she has every time.
Walker's going to set it up for the Cohawks, but she's got 4 seconds left. She's got to get it off. She does. And that one juggles between the rim, and Fleckenstein's going to come up with it as she takes this one for herself. She's going to move it on the inside. He's going to jump into the paint, but it's going to give it to Ryan, back to Schuller, back to Bachman. She moves into the paint and is going to get this shot blocked by Walker. It's going to stay here with the Duhawks. And so, Loras, only 2 team fouls still. So, a total of 4 team fouls for the Duhawks. But this one is going to be picked up by the Cohawks. Peterson.
Toe just on the line, it appears. Be Duhawk basketball.
Ref's trying to get some things in order. As Bachman's going to take this one up. So 1:20 left in the first half. Score still 35-18. As Martin stands alone with the ball. He's going to give this to Bachman from behind the arc. He's going to fake the pass. Schuller, we get a whistle. And we get a foul on Martin.
I think it's going to be a legal screen on Martin.
Her first foul of the evening. Team's third. And, I mean, an aggressive player like Jamie Ryan, Martin herself, always seems to find her, always seems to be in the paint, just trying to make a living from there. As Buck's going to get this one to Wilhelm. A deep two from Peterson. Her first points of the game, too.
Yeah, Peterson averaging about 10 points a game. Bachman's three. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Bachman getting in the action from behind the arc as we approach 20 seconds left in the half.
Yeah, back to Peterson. I mean, like I said earlier, it's surprising that she hasn't been able to get things going. Obviously, in foul trouble early in the first quarter. So that definitely hurts the Cohawks when you're second leading scorer and you're team leader in rebounds is on the bench. That's going to be a charge.
Yeah, foul. Offensive foul on Molly Buck. Haslow falling to the hardwood. So with 2.1 seconds left, are they going to get a last second shot off, or are they just going to run this one down to the triple zeros? Let's find out.
Might have to see a three-quarter court heave here.
That would be amazing. Quite the momentum goer for the Duhawks. If that is the case. If a half quarter heave, then a deep three heave. It looks like they're just going to hold on to this one.
Not a bad decision. You're up 18. You don't really need to.
Yeah. So after two, you're Loras College, Duhawks 38. Co College, Cohawks 20. And we come back, we'll be covering the second half. Welcome back, everybody. Loras College 38, Co College 20. Back for the second half, and it should be a good one. Adam, checking back in with you in terms of ARC play. The men's team for Loras College, they're at Wartburg. How are they doing?
At half, Duhawks were leading 39-32. They are also coming off a win against Wartburg well previously on Saturday. Huge win for them. They won 86-83 in their previous matchups. Hopefully they can get the W against a very solid Wartburg team yet again this year. And as for ARC tournament play again for the women's, we mentioned Luther and UD currently playing right now. They are just in the third quarter. Luther up 24-20. Winner of that game will go face Simpson College, a very tough Simpson team. So we'll keep an eye out on that, as long with the Loras men's team. In this game, obviously, you said Loras up 38-20. We'll look at a couple stats here. Loras shooting the ball really well right now, shooting about 48% from the field and about 43% from deep. Those are very solid numbers for the Duhawks. Let's see if we can keep it up. Now, for the Quahawks, not such a great shooting night for them. I mean, 30% from the field and only 11% from three. So I talked about earlier, if you're the Duhawks, you want them to shoot from three. Not a strong three-point shooting team as we've seen this tonight. So we'll see if Duhawks let them shoot from outside. But we are in for, like you said, a very solid second half. Let's see if the Duhawks can keep things rolling. Hopefully we get and see if Sammy Martin and Fleck can get some more points on the board for this team here.
Yeah, and I just want to talk quickly about Loras' foul. I mean, one of two for free throws. I think that speaks more on Loras' end on containing the aggression and really trying not to be as physical when it comes to defensive play. I mean, one of two for free throws just speaks for itself how well they're playing defensively, holding them to 20 points. But also this, as a second half, is right here, right now.
Loras will start with the ball in the second half. Fleck will bring it up for the Duhawks.
Fleck is signed. Ankle breaking.
Duhawks moving the ball well right now.
Indeed. Bachman's going to try to set it back up.
Now, you know, we had mentioned another Loras team. We can't forget to show love. Bachman, mid-range, good.
That one's good.
Good shot there from Sierra. Along with the two basketball teams, Loras men's volleyball team is at Augustana right now. Just won the second set. They're up 2-0. Looking to go for a sweep here as they enter the third. So good luck to them the rest of the night. Hopefully they can come out with a sweep here.
Yeah, that pass by Buck was intended on the inside but intercepted by Flankenstein. She's going to get that to Schuler. Schuler to Haslow. Bachman for a three. And yeah, that one's good.
Chi-town, baby. Chi-town.
There we go. She's been hot from downtown.
13 for Bachman tonight.
13 points for Bachman.
Good find there.
There we go. Moving in on the inside.
Good find.
And we talked about the fouls for Loras. Schuler was just standing there with her hands up. Yep. Bachman going to give this one to Fleckenstein. Fleckenstein going to give it to Martin as she's going to work on the inside and try to get in the paint. Spinning around and puts that one in. Duhawks up by 23.
Oh, Southern pushing it, going right coast to coast. I mean, that's just not great transition defense there from the Duhawks. I mean, Southern saw they were getting back slow and took advantage of it. Fleck drive, going to be a kick ball violation. Got Jamie Ryan and Hanlon Thiele checking in for Schuler and Fleckenstein.
Thiele hit back-to-back three-pointers before the first half closed out. Can she continue that streak here in the second half? We will find out as Bachman's going to inbound this one. She's got Ryan from the three-point line. He's going to give it back to Bachman. Bachman. Thiele for a three, and that one's good.
Oh, yeah.
So back-to-back-to-back three-pointers for Thiele. 9 points on the night, and you guessed it. All of those points are from behind the arc. Southard's going to give it.
Good help D from Haslow there. Steal by Thiele. Duhawks are going to push here.
Indeed they are. Haslow's going to give it to Martin as she gets.
Good block there from Southard. Very nice block there.
Coe, lucky that one wasn't a foul, just out on them. And Walker's going to check in for Wissner.
Thiele didn't inbound the ball.
Bachman juggles that one in the hands of Buck.
Oh.
But off the hand of Buck as this one.
Just never had a grasp with the ball.
Yeah.
That's unfortunate for Buck.
But lost it. So it's going to be a Loras ball. Haslow to inbound. She's giving this one to Bachman, who's going to set it up at the top. Haslow's going to try to work in on the inside, but she's going to dish this to Martin. And she's got herself some points right there. 12 on the night for her.
And again, I mean, Coe just being a little too aggressive on the off-ball defense, allowing Loras to get a lot of those backdoor cuts. And that's good help defense there from Haslow.
Yes. Southard tempted to go on the inside, but she's going to stay back and give this one to Peterson. Peterson.
Good help.
Recovers that. Gives it to Buck. She thought about a three, but it's going to take it in from the paint. And that good little floater's good.
Good floater.
So even though the Duhawks are halfway to 100, Coe trying to make some noise of their own. So we're going to get a Cohawk timeout here. So Loras, 50, and Coe, 26. Bachman, 13. Martin, 12. Two leading scorers of the night for the Duhawks. They're having themselves a night. And can't forget, Thiel's back-to-back three-pointers. From behind the arc, like Adam said, 8 of 16 for Loras. 1 of 9 for the Cohawks. I mean, like we talked about in the first half, they've really been putting up a lot of shots, but they just haven't been able to let them fall. No. Loras, on the other hand, they've been doing really well. I mean, 50% from the three-point line, that's really good for them.
I mean, like I said, it's just not falling for Coe tonight. I mean, 12 of 34. They're getting very, very solid shots. They are all good looks. They just can't seem to take the lid off the rim. Wittenbaugh midi.
Oh, that one's good. Aggressively from the charity line. Southard's going to take this for herself. Buck working in from behind the arc's going to get this to Walker.
Well, and I look at it, we talk about Coe and, I mean, the shooting struggles, but looking at their roster right now, they don't have a single senior on the team. I mean, Kaylin Peterson, a sophomore. I mean, she's obviously the double-double machine. Mm-hmm. I mean, they definitely have a bright future in this program, all very young, so I wouldn't be surprised over these next couple of years and if these girls really start to figure it out, and wouldn't be surprised if they become a force in the ARC here in a couple of years.
So Emily Slide checks in for the Cohawks. And Daniela Gerald is going to check in for the Duhawks. As Wismer's going to get a foul here. Great job by Fleckenstein drawing that one and going to give her team another opportunity to get some points. She's been a machine offensively and defensively, not just tonight but all year.
Oh, yeah. She loves taking charges. Loves taking those charges for the Duhawks and getting them the ball back, which that's good to have. That's good to have on the team, someone that will put their body on the line and take some hits.
Thiel's going to hand this off to Fleckenstein. Back to Thiel from behind the arc. Girelli is going to give this to Ryan, that spark plug of the Loras College Duhawk team. Fleckenstein's going to try to put this one up. Bit of a Hail Mary shot there.
Not entirely sure what they're calling here. Maybe possibly blood. Yeah, it looks like she's.
I think so.
Bleeding on the leg. They're gonna tape up the. They're gonna tape up the cut. And probably come out and clean the court. Maybe.
I think they may have caught it in time before. It got onto the court. So good call by the ref.
Lovely.
Walker's gonna take this for the Cohawks. She's got 4 points on the night, so as much as she's been playing, she's been kind of a puzzle piece that they've needed to help other players excel in their position.
And again, like I said, young. She's a freshman on the team, so she definitely has a bright future for the Cohawks.
Windsor's pass intercepted by Ryan, kicking it to Wittenbaugh. A three.
Jarrell, no good.
Jarrell misses that one, picked up by Wisner again. She's going to go coast to coast and just off the back of the hoop.
Cannot get that lid off the bucket tonight.
Jarrell's going to kick this Thiele. To Thiele for a three, yeah, and that
baby.
One's good.
Chi-town.
Go. Calling another timeout here. 12 points for Thiele. All of those from behind the arc. 55-26, 4:47 left here in the third period. What a night for the Duhawks in ARC first-round tournament play.
Yeah, they want that conference title bad, and it's shown right now. Checking back into the other first-round game of the women's ARC tournament. Luther still leading UD with 35-30 with 3:15 left in the third. And that'd be a very solid upset for Luther if they can manage to pull off the victory against UD and then travel to Simpson for the semifinal game.
And Luther was here just last week, last Monday, and the Duhawks took them down 78-63. Walker's taking this one up for herself. Sly's going to give it back to Walker for a three, and that one, no good. So Emily Sly checks into the game for Co. 14-22 for field goals. 1 of 1 from behind the arc. Her bread and butter is inside the paint. Fleckenstein's going to get a whistle here.
Yeah. We're going to call that on Jarrell.
So South Hart to Walker, and another whistle. It's going to be a travel. Walker was walking too much on that one.
Interesting. Didn't really. I personally didn't see the travel there. So, I mean, the ref saw it. We'll go with that.
The ref is closer than we are.
Yeah,
but
seriously.
Coach Martin getting some last-minute encouragement and last-minute words in here as Megan Murray checks into the game for the first time. She's going to bounce past that one to Thiele, to Haslell, back to Murray. She's going to find Fleckenstein, but intercepted.
Good poke from Murray. It's a good way to come back after a turnover. Oh, Haslell just dribbles off her own foot. Heinzen not happy with these last two possessions from the Duhawks.
So Sly checks back into the game. Walker, a three, and that one's good.
There it is.
Her first of the night.
There
Perhaps
they go.
A little momentum as Murray's going to take this up.
Quick score check for the Loras men's basketball team. With early in the second half, they were, with 18 minutes left, they were up 46-34. Thiele again. Oh, yeah. Feeling it from downtown.
I think, yep, has not missed from behind the arc. 15 points from her, and Fleckenstein delivered a sharp pass to Thiele to capitalize on that three as Wittenbaugh is trying to take on Sly inside the paint. Going to give this one to Walker, but we're going to get a whistle. Too much time in the paint for the Cohawks, and a new set of fresh legs come in for both teams. Martin, Schuler, and Ryan for the Duhawks. Thiele, Wittenbaugh, and Fleckenstein are going to get a much-needed rest and a much-earned one, too. So 58-29, 3 minutes left in the third period. Haslow's going to give this to Ryan. Ryan to Murray. Murray back to Schuler. To Ryan, Schuler's going to try to get it to Murray, and she does. Ooh. Murray's going to go inside, but
Haslell
kicks it out to Haslell.
Chi-town.
Just short for that one. And a well-rounded team right there as everyone got a chance at the ball there for the Duhawks. And Buck decided she was going to stay back instead of drive in. Walker for a three, and that one's no good. Wilhelm's going to step out And Fleckenstein's back in for Haslow. We talk so much about the little things, not stepping out of bounds, turnovers, this, that. And it just happens to everybody. I think it's happened a lot to Co here. And Loras has done a really good job on capitalizing on those little things. And the past, you know, two possessions that we had talked about, Coach Hines was a little upset, but it happens to everyone. And I think as long as you respond versus react, Frankenstein.
Nice little feed there from Martin.
Putting on a show here tonight. 11 points for her. Buck. Back to Wilhelm. Wilhelm. He's going to get this one to Mueller. Southard, a three, and that one no good. Picked up by Sammy Martin. She's going to take this for herself. Gives it to Ryan. Ryan Schuler for a three, and that one's good.
Oh, yeah, baby.
In the corner.
Everything seems to be dropping for the Dewhawks, and nothing seems to be dropping for the Cohawks right now.
Loras, 11 of 21 from behind the arc, 52%. Southard's going to drive in, kicks it out to Mueller. Pearson, juggling act here. And that doesn't fall off of a Dewhawk, and that Dewhawk is Jamie Ryan. So Windsor checks into the game for Mueller, and Haslow checks in for Ryan. A minute left here in the third period. Southard to inbound. Gets it to Wismer for a three, and that one fails to fall. Picked up by Haslow. Haslow to Fleckenstein.
Just an off game for Peterson and Wisner, the two leading scorers. Wisner with two. Martin's layup no good. Wisner with two and Peterson with four. Definitely not their night, and it really doesn't seem to be the Cohawks' night with shooting. You know they're going to go back and wish they could have had more shots to fall, but it happens to the best of us.
Murray going to get it to Haslow. She's been going from behind arc. She's put up a few shots, haven't been able to get them to fall as we get a stoppage of play and a whistle.
It's going to be a foul on Wilhelmy.
Macy Rogers is going to check in for Katie Wilhelm. And, I mean, really from behind the arc, we've seen Hannah Thiel 15 points. I mean, that's just unheard of.
Yeah, Thiele, all 15 just from deep. I mean, when you're feeling it, you're feeling it. Fleck shot, no good. Rebound by Peterson. Souther's going to bring it up. Good move from Wisner. She draws a foul. She'll go to the line for two. Good find there from Souther to see Wisner running opposite side and to thread the needle and get that pass to her.
So Martin's second foul of the night, and that falls for Wisner. Team's third foul. She makes the first. And the second, good as well. Southard playing aggressive full court press. Two 6 seconds left. Fleckenstein going to get a try to the last second shot off. Can't she do it? Just throws it up.
Oh.
A left-handed shot there. No good. So at the end of three, 63-31 here at Lillis J. Court, your Dewhawks up big. The winner of this game will take on Wartburg. And the winner of that Luther UD game will take on Simpson. Should be a great matchup between both teams in the semifinal.
Yeah, and looking at that Luther-UD game, going to be a very tight finish. At the start of the fourth quarter, Luther leads 38-36. And like I said, like we said before, Simpson just full of talent, full of strong players, and it definitely will be an exciting game on that side of the bracket.
As the DuHawks walk out for what could be one last time in the fourth quarter here at Lillis J. Court. Fleckenstein, Jarelli, Martin, Jarrell, Schuler, and Haslow. Windsor gonna get this one up. Can't get that lid off the hoop. Fleckenstein. A shot
Schuler,
to Schuler, and that one no good. Picked up by Martin.
Martin's going to draw the foul. She'll go to the line for two.
Martin from the line this year, 72-91, 79%. That is great. That one, not surprised it falls. And the second does the same. So 65-31 to start off the fourth quarter. She's got 14 points, Martin. Leads the team.
Charge attempt. Good take there from Haslow. It's unfortunate because she couldn't get it, but forced the miss. DuHawks moving around. Jarrell swings it to Haslow. Oh.
Jarrell's going to get it into Martin. Martin working it on the inside and gets that off the glass. Such a powerful player on the inside.
So good down low. You get it to her and expect her to find a way to get to the rack and score.
Southard's going to give it to Buck. She decides to hold it from a three. Back to Southard. Looks like she wants to give it in on the inside, but it's going to settle for Buck. Winsner. It's going to get a pick from Rogers. Buck, a two, and that one no good. Rebounded by Martin. She's going to take this for herself as she's got, looks like the pass was intended for Jarrell. But intercepted by Wisner. So Southard is going to set something up for the Quahawks. Buck wanted a three, but is going to give it to Rogers.
Travel call. Travel on Rogers.
Wittenbaugh, Thiele, and Ryan checking into the game.
You know, we talk about Coe not being able to get their shots to fall tonight, but, I mean, they 18 turnovers right now at this point in the game. Obviously, that's just not – It's not going to get a team a victory if you have that many turnovers throughout almost three and a half quarters. So, that's obviously a big reason for Coach struggles tonight. But
Martin.
Wittenbaugh is going to get called for travel.
Wittenbaugh gets called for a travel there, and Southard is going to take this one up for the Quahawks. Wittenbaugh and Martin out on the court at the same time. Quahawks definitely have their hands full down low. Peterson's going to get a screen here in the paint.
Good hand there from Jarrell. Very nice poke.
Jarrell gets the ball out, but it will stay with the Quahawks as Allison Udelhofen's going to check in for Sammy Martin, her first time coming out tonight. And that falls for Winsner.
Good defense from Jarrell, just better offense from Wisner.
Sealy, 15 points on the night for her. She actually leads the team in points. As Ryan is going to give this one to Jarrell. Wittenbaugh working in on the inside. He's going to get this one blocked by Peterson. And Walker's the one that comes up with it as she takes it down for the Cohawks. Southard, a three. And that one, no good, picked up by Teeley. Teeley's going to get it to Jarrell. She's going to work it on the inside, but kicks it out to Ryan for a three. And that one, no good, off of a Cohawk, so it'll stay with the Dewhawks. Jarrell to inbound. Going to give it to Ryan. Back to Jarrell, who will crisp pass to Teeley for a three. Ooh, and that one doesn't fall in and out. Buck going to go down, but he's going to kick it out to Mueller. No good. Picked up by Wimbaugh. Gets it to Jarrell. Puts the brakes on, but dishes it out to Wittenbaugh. Back to Jarrell. Going to try to work it down low here to Udelhofen. She's going to go in and gets it blocked by Pearson. So Buck's going to slow things down. Is going to give it to Ella Mueller.
Walker from three. That's good.
Jarrell is going to try to come up with something of her own as Walker banks that three.
Two Hawks swinging around. Jarrell kick out to Thiele. Thiele from deep. Just short. Emler will bring it up.
Walker, can she go back for threes?
Oh,
and
yeah.
She does.
I mean.
So back-to-back threes for Walker.
Walker now at 13 for the night.
You're going to get a whistle here and a timeout from Coach Hines.
Great game from Walker. She sees Peterson, Wisner both struggling to get it going. Great for them to find a third option and get some points on the board for them.
So a timeout here, 5 minutes left, and what could possibly be the Cohawks' last game of the year. But if it is, what a season they have had. Fought hard every game, put in effort every day at practice, and hate to see it end for them like this. So Megan Murray and the freshman Silviana Scarsella is going to check in for the Dewhawks. Udelhofen, Teeley, and Wittenbaugh remain out on the court. Scarsella to Wittenbaugh to Teeley. Getting handed off to Murray as she goes in on the inside. We'll kick it back out to Teeley. 8 seconds left on the shot clock. Dewhawks got to come up with something quick. A jumper by Wittenbaugh that's blocked. Picked up.
Himmler will bring it up for the Cohawks.
A three, and that one's no good. Picked up by
Kickball. Quick update for the Loras men's basketball team. With 9:26 left in the second half, they lead 65-62. They are only up by three after being up 10 with 11 minutes left in the second. That game, we're going to see another nail biter between those two teams. Walker for three. That's good.
Huh.
16 from Walker.
16, like Adam said.
Heck, Murray, good take.
Her first points of the night from Megan Murray. It's only the second time in the game for her. As the Dewhawks close to 70 points. Tipped by Udelhoff, and it'll stay here with the Duhawks.
Going to be a foul on Udelhoffen. Checking into the game for the Duhawks is going to be number 33, Allie Brownson, in for Scarsella.
Walker shot no good. A juggling act down deep. And it's off a Duhawk, so it'll stay here with Co.
Can be a foul on Wittenbaugh, actually.
Maya Lidgreen will come in for Co. She replaces Wilhelm. Walker, a three. Can this fall? And no, just off the rim. Out of bounds on Udelhofer. So three whistle stoppages here, all in Co's favor.
Checking into the game for the Duhawks is going to, making her first appearance, is going to be number four, Cassie Morozik, in for Wittenbaugh.
Mueller. And give it to Walker. Another three. And that one, no good, picked up by Udelhofen. Going to give it to Murray. Murray's going to lead Brownson. But that one just a little too far out of reach for her.
Idea was there. Just a little too hard on the pass.
So Walker's going to check out. She's had quite the night from the three-point line. Really helped them get that three-point percentage up. Even though they're 5 of 22, she herself has had quite the game. 4 of 8 from the three-point line, 6 of 13 for field goals. A whistle here, and it'll stay with Co. So as we approach 3 minutes left in the game, Co at this point fighting for some type of miracle that they can try to stir up, as this one from Brownson doesn't go in. Rebounded by Co.
Good deed there from Murray. Good hand for Murray. That's going to be another steal for the Duhawks.
So a poke from Murray, and she takes this one. Murray's going to give it to Brownson, to Udelhofen, to Mozrek. Udelhofen's going to go in, going to kick it out to Brownson. She goes into the paint for a shot, and that's blocked. Udelhofen using her height to draw the foul. Mara Pugh checks in for the Cohawks, and Sylvia Scarcella is going to check in for Megan Murray. Udelhofen has two shots, and 2 minutes remain in the game. First one falls. Second one, just short. Picked up by Brownson. Cassidy's going to give it to Udelhofen for
deep.
A three. And that one just off the backboard in the rim. And Mozrek's going
to
get fouled.
Morozik's
she'll have two.
Going to the line.
Her first time at the line tonight. She's got an opportunity to get some points and banks the first one. And the second one's good, too. 72 to 42, up by 30. with a minute 50 left in the game. So a turnover for the Co. Cassidy Randall checks in for Loras. Scarcella's going to get this to Cassidy.
Randall's going to drive. Oh, way too easy. Great, great take from Randall there.
Two Hawks ball.
Garcella's going to bring it up for the Dewhawks.
Scarcella tries to get that to Bronson, and she does.
Cassidy to Cassidy.
That one poked away. Can Cassidy stop him? For now, she does, but an opportunity to get 2 points for Co.
Lindgren will go to the line.
Cassidy's first foul of the night. She's got 2 points of her own, both off of free throws.
Checking in for the Dewhawks, in for Scarcella. It'll be number 23, Becca Conlis.
So 52 seconds left, and that shot's good. So a 31-point lead now for Loras. Cassidy.
Randall drives.
Had a choice, but dishes it.
Conlis go to Morozic.
Morozic to Brownson. Brownson.
Randall, Chi-Town.
For three, yeah! And that one's good. Oh, 77-43, 26 seconds left, and I think it's safe to say the Dewhawks got this one secured.
Becca Conlis is just going to dribble it out for the Dewhawks. And Dewhawks are moving on to the semifinals of the ARC Conference Tournament after a 77-43 win over Coe College. Great performance out of them. Quick update for the men's basketball team. With about 3 minutes left, they are up 77-59 in the second half. You never know with 3 minutes left. It'll either come down to the wire or they might close that one out.
So from Lillis Court, signing off Matt and Adam, the Dewhawks live to fight another day. 77-43 victory. Loras will take on the Wartburg Knights in what should be a phenomenal semifinal showdown. Thanks and have a great night.